My name is Richard Schenkman. I directed and co-produced Jerome Bixby's The Man from Earth.
The movie came from the final screenplay of a great writer, Jerome Bixby. It tells the story of John Oldman, a professor who challenges his friends with a wild story.
What if a man from the upper Paleolithic survived until the present day?
Yeah, the pancreas turns over cells every 24 hours, the stomach lining, in 3 days, the entire body. In 7 years, but the process falters. Now, if a quirk in his immune system led to perfect detox, perfect renewal, then yeah, he could duck decay.
We were just talking about a caveman who survives until the present time.
There have always been legends of such a thing, a creature, not quite human, taking not the blood, but the life force itself.
Even though the whole movie was basically eight people in a room talking, it took us, both the actors and the audience, on a fantastic sci-fi journey through history, philosophy, religion, ethics. Really, it's science fiction of the mind.
Jerome Bixby first began thinking about The Man from Earth more than 50 years ago. In fact, he explored some of the same ideas in a classic Star Trek episode entitled Requiem for Methuselah.
Bixby was a great thinker and an important writer. He wrote the story It's a Good Life, which became one of the most beloved Twilight Zone episodes of all time. And he wrote Fantastic Voyage, one of my personal favorite science fiction movies ever.
The Man from Earth was his final script.
When Richard got his hands on the screenplay, he knew it was brilliant, but it did need some work before it could be filmed. Unfortunately, Mr. Bixby was no longer around, but with Emerson's blessings, Richard took that screenplay and he polished it till it shone like a diamond.
We never thought that our tiny little ultra-low-budget movie would be seen by so many people. But with the rise of the internet and file sharing and downloading, the movie was passed hand-to-hand, person-to-person, until literally millions of people had seen it.
I'll never forget the week we jumped almost 8,000% on the IMDb movie meter. I mean, we went from nowhere to number 10, and the next week we were the most searched science fiction film on the site.
Naturally, when people love a character or a story, they want to know more. They've been asking me about a Man from Earth sequels pretty much since the film first came out. And for the longest time, I said, no way. But the more I thought about John Oldman, the more I realized there was more for this man to say and do. And so we created The Man from Earth, the series. Because with a series, we can tell so many more stories and really develop the characters.
Bottom line is, The Man from Earth was and is an internet phenomenon. So now that we're ready to get busy on the series, we're turning directly to the internet to kickstart this project.
We're keeping the perks simple because we want it to be easy and affordable for everyone to participate. We understand that for many of the movie's fans, $5 is a lot of money, but we want everyone who loved The Man from Earth to be part of this.
Well, I'll be back for the series.
Love the script, and we're looking forward to it.
Hey, if there's something for me to do in it, I'll be there too.
What's Man from Earth without Professor Jenkins? Somebody's got to be the bad guy.
Please get involved, and please be sure to tell all your friends about the project. The Man from Earth series is your show. We want you on board, and we want you to be the very first to see it.